Hello, my name's Carrie and I'm one of the senior active lifestyle officers at Cambridge City Council. Today I'm here at the Meadows Community Centre filming one of our exercise referral long-term conditions classes. This class in particular is suited to you if you have some mobility problems and if you use mobility aids such as a walking frame or walking stick to help you get around. The class is led by our experienced and qualified exercise referral instructor Marlene, and you can only access this class should you have had a referral from a health professional. On details on how you can obtain a referral, please continue to watch this video and further information on this will be provided at the end. Alternatively, you can do these exercises whenever you wish via this YouTube link. Please be advised that you're doing so at your own risk, and should you experience any sharp pain, to stop the exercise immediately. If you experience some fatigue or discomfort, please rest and recommence with the exercises when you are able. Remember, you're doing this within your own time and within your own levels of ability. We hope you enjoy the session and we hope that you get lots of benefit from it.
Hello, my name is Marlene. I teach the long-term conditioning class, which are part of the GP referral scheme. If you would like to know more about these classes, there will be all the information at the end of this video. Right, girls. Sitting forward of that chair. That's it, let's get the feet moving. Are you okay, seated, Jean? You don't want your lift underneath you? Do you want to stand? You like to stand, that's okay. Marching there. Not the way young Landry is, but she's normally here by now, so she doesn't come late. She always gets here early, doesn't she, young Landry? So sometimes she's not missed for a long time, has she?
No.
She only missed before Christmas when her daughter was here from America. Yeah, but she might have rung my house phone. And then there'll be a message on my house phone. Okay, let's have a little tap out. Let's get the knees moving out as well, not just the feet. Right, so if you've got a hip problem, you might not want to take so far, but just move it a little bit. There. Out we go. So you don't want to do warm-ups. Off we go. Let's add it on. Out we go. Out we go. Two. Three, back to the march. So if your back gets tired, you can sit back and have a back break, okay? All right, and have a little rest out. But if you can sit forward and keep your back working, it's a good exercise in itself, okay? Two, three, let's have a heel tap, just to loosen up those knee joints, and back, nice and steady. And back, and heel, and back. And heel, and back, and heel, and back, and heel, and back to that march. So I'll take it you're all feeling well today. Yeah, good. It's a lovely day outside, nice and sunny. Yeah, cheers you up a little bit, doesn't it, when it's sunshiny? Okay, one shoulder. Let's start small. Start small, going round. So. You can increase that range of movement as you go. Remember, we don't want any pain. Round we go. Then you're drawing a circle with the elbow. Round we go. Good. Okay, let's try the other one. So starting small. Bigger circle with the elbow if you can. Round we go. Main thing is to listen to your body. Okay, in the warm-up, everything should feel easy. It shouldn't be difficult, you shouldn't be breathing heavily, you shouldn't be in any some pains, you should feel comfortable. And back to that march. Back to that march. Okay, let's have a tap out again. Adding the arm. So we're gonna add a few more arms this time round. Have a go. Make sure you're taking the knee as well as the foot out with you, so you are warming up your hips. Out we go. Four, three, two, and back to that lunge. Okay. So we're going to do a little heel toe to loosen up the ankles a little bit more. So we've got heel, toe, heel. That's it. If you're standing, it's exactly the same as if you're seated. There, there. Remember, if you're standing and you've got a chair in front of you, make sure you're safe. You can put your hands on the chair. If you're standing near a wall or a table in your house, make sure you can put your hands on those in case you need a little bit of help in your balance.
This might be helpful for standing up.
Does it hurt your back? Okay, put your hand down there then if it hurts your back, and just use that as a support. Other leg. Have a go. Does that help? Yes. If you just put your hands like that, it helps to support your back if it's feeling a little bit tired. I think this does tend to make you rock back a little bit. So is your knee all right, Barbara? Knee okay? Yeah. And back to the march. Off we go. Three, two, okay, heel taps, heel. Right, so this time, let's add both arms. So it's nice and steady, but we're getting the arms involved now. It's a little bit of a row. There, don't ram back. Just gently pull the elbows back. There. Sitting up tall, or if your back's tired, you might want to put a cushion behind you to support and sit a little bit back. There, pull, reach, and back to the march. Off we go. Are you warm enough now? Is it feeling warmer? Good. Okay, so we're going to go into a bit more mobility. Sitting up nice and tall, arms here. If your arms get tired there, just put them on your body. Ready, so we're just going to go turn, back to the front, okay? Let your head go with you. That's it, good. Head go with you. Look behind and front. Turn. Now if you're standing, you must try and keep your hips forward. Otherwise you're going to twist your knees and not your, what we should be twisting, just warming up the spine. There. Turn. Front. Turn. Good. There. Two more. Turn. Look behind. Front. Quite important, this exercise, I think. Especially if you drive. You're still driving. You know, turning to look behind. You need to keep that back mobile. Even if you're a passenger, you know, turning to put your seat safety belt on. Okay, you do need that to keep that twist going. And the head turn, especially if you're reversing. There, let's go. Okay, feet still. We're going to do a side bend. So back nice and tall, arms at the side. Right, really lift up here. We're going straight to the side. There. And up. And straight to the side, go as far as you feel comfortable, and up. You might find,
is it lovely?
Mm-hmm. You might find that you can go a little bit further. And up, and over, and up, and over. Now remember to keep the breathing going. Don't hold. Breathe in and out throughout the exercises and over. And there. One more. And up we come. Okay, let's go. Let's try a few knee lifts. So we're just tapping up. Don't go too high. Just lifting up. See how your hips are feeling. There we go. The opposite hand, let the coordination work. Opposite hand, keeping the back up tall. That's it. 3, 2, 1. And back to the march. See if we can get the arms going a little bit more now. Off we go. Okay, we need to do a little bit of stretching. So, from seated stretch, we take the arms, chest stretch, we take the arms behind. Now, you can use the chair to pull back. If that's too much, you just put your hands behind and pull the shoulders back. If you're standing, you will be pulling back there. There and pulling back. Hold it. And release. Well done. Right. Bring one arm across. We're going to do a shoulder stretch. So you put your hand on the shoulder. The other hand goes above the elbow. And then we press the arm towards the neck or chest area. So you're getting a stretch here. Press. And release. Other one, hand on your shoulder. Hand above your elbow and press. There. This is where we tend to hold the breath when we're doing stretches. Try and keep it going in and out, okay? And release, let's go. Off we go. Keeping that blood flowing around the body, okay? Off we go. Okay, so we're going to do a calf stretch. Quite important. Keeps the muscles at the back of the leg stretched out, flexible, helps us with walking. There. So, bring the foot forward. Now, if you're sat too far back, you won't be able to do this properly. You must move forward. So you have to move forward to the edge of your chair. Bring the leg forward so it's nice and straight. Hand goes on the opposite leg. And then back nice and tall and come forward. Now, as you can see, my toe is coming towards my knee, and this will straight away cause a stretch on that calf. If you're standing, you need to stand. You may have your chair in front of you. Chair in front of you, hands on the chair, and stepping into this one. If you're more able, you might just want to put your hands on your thigh there. Put that back toe, it must be forward. Otherwise, you won't get the stretch. So hands on there, the support, hold the stretch, and change legs. That's it. Either stepping back if you're standing, or remember if you're seated, edge of the chair, there, back nice and tall, and coming forward. Toe up. Can you feel that stretch? Should be able to feel it round here, and hold. And up we come. Okay, let's get the arms moving. Nice and steady. Side stretch. Arm down, reaching up and over. Reaching up and over there. See if we can get the feet just moving a little bit. So we're keeping everything moving. That's it. Now look, I've put this other hand on the chair to support my back. If you're standing, you might want it on your hip to support the back. And release down. Okay, standing, reaching up and over. So you should feel the stretch on your side. There. Remember, if you're seated, hand on the chair to support the back. Straight to the side, don't lean forward. That pull on yours. And hold. 2, 3, 2, 1, and release. Off we go. Off we go. Nice and warm in here now, isn't it? 2, 3. Okay. I'll go. A little bit quicker now. Tap it out. Get that knee going. Good. Take the arm out. Out we go. Back to the march. and reach, reach and back, reach and back, and reach and back, and reach. Trying to keep the feet moving at the same time, if you can, and back. Right, so we're going to reach over that way. Pick something up over there. So you've got a little turn and reach, reach and reach and back and reach. See if you can turn the body. We've warmed them up. We've warmed that movement up, so you should be able to just have a little turn there, there. What about reaching high? You go up, reach up, over that way and reach and back to that march. Okay, that's good. Just a little bit more and then we'll get on to, if any of you wish to stand a little bit. Anybody want to stand? Come on, stand. Anybody else you want to stand? Okay, that's good. When you've warmed up, you might feel like you want to work a little bit harder. Get some weight bearing work through the hips and the knees whilst just standing. Tap out. And then I'll teach you this little dance routine which the class know very well. Some people might not know, okay? Out we go, out we go, out we go. 4, 3, 2, back to that march, let's go. Okay, so if you want to stand behind your chair, don't forget we've got feet back, body forward, and you might want to push on the chair, on your legs. Some of you are able to do it without, but standing up, pushing your feet into the ground, stand up. When you're ready. If you want to stay seated, then don't. But if you want to stand, and then round the back of your chair. Round the back of your chair. Stand behind there. That's good. Right. So I'm just going to go through this. Slowly. Right, so we're going to do the arm actions for the Macarena. Okay, not only is it a bit of fun, it's also quite useful for if you're having to stand and do things with your arms, hanging the washing out, putting something in a cupboard, something down low. It's a good practice for that and it works, helps with your balance. Okay, so let's just have a little practice, shall we? So we bring the arm out, out, up, up, shoulders, shoulders, head, head, hip, hip, behind, wiggle it. So you all know what to wiggle. You can't wiggle that bit. If you're seated, you can have a wiggle on your shoulders. There, if you want to. Okay, let's try it again. Out, out. Up, up. Shoulders, shoulders. Head, head. Hips, good memory. Behind and wiggle. Okay. Let's get the music on. That's the main thing, and then we do a few other things which we'll do as we go along. Okay, we have a little knee, soft knees, soft knees. So if you're seated, you're seated as well. If you're doing it seated, you've just got your feet moving. Hips going, you're standing a little bit. Ready, let's go. Let's go slow first. We can do this at slow speed, and then we can do it quicker as we go, get going. We know what we're doing. It's a good memory test as well. Hip, hip, behind, behind, wiggle it, something, shoulders, hips. Right, let's do a little bit quicker, shall we? Let's have a go. And out, out, up, up. Shoulders, head, hips, behind, wiggle it. And again, and out, out, up, up. If you start to get a bit tired and you're standing, do sit down. And out, out, up, up. And hips, behind, wiggle. Okay, hold it there. Wide legs. So we're doing a bit of wide base swaying. Right there. So standing there, if you're seated, here, tap it out. Let's have some arms. That's too much. You can just keep your legs still. Get the arms going. Or if your arms are tired, you bring them down. Or you can just do the legs. Two, three. Okay, back to that march. And if you get tired, take the arms out, because they're the ones that usually make the heart rate go up. Put your arms down and keep your feet pumping. There. Four, three, two. Let's go back to arms. Ready? And out, out, up, up. Shoulders, head, hips, behind. Have a little shake out. Ready? Arms. And out, out, up, up. Shoulders, head, hips, behind, shake it. Two, three, and one, two, up, up. Shoulders, head, hips, behind, shake it. Right, let's go back to that wide base. So if you're standing, you would be behind your chair. Oops, behind your chair. Make sure if you need to, you can. Put your hands like this. Support, or hands stay on, or you can do the sway. Depends on how well balanced you are. Swap and change it. Sit, well done. Let's have a march. Same again. Standing, feet want some balance help. You've got your hand on. Swap it. Or you can just hold on there. Well done. Are we all okay to stay standing a bit? If you need to sit down, and I'll show you this little routine that we're going to do. This is your last one, and then we're going to go on to strength training. Okay, so we've got like a little step that goes step, 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 and then you pick the leg up a little bit if you can. There. So you can do this, seated or standing, like that. Okay, let's all get together, let's just march it out. Right, so you go that way, step, step. So I've got the chair to hold on to if I'm standing there. Bringing the leg just up there. Okay, let's keep it going. You're seated, you're there. One, two. Now, some of you have managed to master the art of the arms. If that's too tricky, don't worry. Just leave it. Just see if you can get the tap on there. Some of you might want to try this one. Open, cross, open, tap. Three, four, there. One, two, three, there. One, two, three, there. One, two, three, there. Okay, let's have a little rest. Little rest. Little rest. Breathing going. Remember, any time if you want, you can stop and get a drink. Don't forget that. March it there. Okay, we're going to do tapping to the side. Tap to the side. Out we go. Out we go. That's good. Make sure your knees are going, not just your foot, your knees. Four, six, three, two, back to that little march. Little march. Remember, if you're standing, you can now come down, sit down, have a little break, work it seated. Then if you feel okay again, you can go and stand back up. Are we all okay, class? Good. Four, three. Okay, three and a little knee. One, two, three, knee. One, two, three, knee. For those who want to use the arms, it's open, cross, open, tap. Bit of a coordination this, but part of you worked it. Up, one, two, three, up, one, two, three, up. Back to that arch. Have a little break. Remember, if the arms are too much, ease the arms off. Just make everything easy. Let's have a tap out. Tap it now. Two, three. Back to the march. Okay, we're going to have a go at doing the seated box show it standing as well. Seated box step is just heel, heel, toe, toe. Heel, heel, toe, toe. Heel, heel, toe, toe. If you're standing, you might be behind the chair. You'll be walking into the chair and back. So you're going toe, right, that's it. Forward, forward, back, back. You can hold on. Heel, heel, back, back. Forward, forward, back, back. And back to the march. Nice and steady. Two. Three. Four. Ready? Tap out. Just have a rest, Bob. Have a little rest. Four, three, two, back to the march. Back to, keep the head up, looking forward. Okay, ready, and one, two, three, knee. Nearly there, we're nearly there, nearly there. Well done. Just feet moving a little bit. Nice and easy. Just easy now. We're just going to come down a little bit because you've worked quite hard so far. You just need to ease it off. Bring this heart rate down. Just 8, is it, Barbara? Hurts. Is it better if it's kept straight? Hold it out straight for a bit. There, marching it there. Hold on.
Something new.
Something new. March it there. Little tap, so everything's easy now. We don't have to use the arms. If the arms are coming, if you want, if some people like using arms, just little easy arms. Two, and back to the march. Okay. So before we sit down and do the strength training, I would like to see you walking. Okay. So, if you'd like to walk, keep it in your own little area, like we normally do. Do you want to walk, Barbara? Okay, so we want you to stand up tall, try and keep your shoulders relaxed, and walking, pulling your tummy muscles a little bit, if you can remember to practice that heel tuck. So just do normal speed walk. Off we go. Let's have a look. Nice and easy, relaxed walking. You're coming down. Now, careful when you go round something, because that's when people tend to go dizzy. So do take it a little bit slower, going round. You can only work within the space you've got. So we're walking round, maybe if you've got somewhere, just carefully walking round, and then back. Now, if you've got a stick or a walker or a frame, you may need to use that to practice your walking with. Put ice on your hips. Yeah. Yeah, but make sure you don't put straight ice on. You've got a in a plastic bag. Yeah, a plastic bag. Or you put it on. Make sure you've got a bit of tea towel over. Put it on. Okay then, group. When you've finished, in the back of your chair. We were going to do some lunges today. We need to do a few lunges before we sit down and do some strength training on the upper body. Okay. So, if my class would like to turn that way, remember you're putting your hand on the chair, feet apart, and your chair's there for you to hold on to should you need it. That's it, Brenda, if you'd like to stand behind your chair to do your lunges. Now remember, you're only bending as far as you can. Some of you will only do a step forward and a step back, but that's okay, because that's getting you in that movement. If you step forward, make sure you step back and your feet are apart, because it's better balance. Okay, don't bring your feet together. Make sure they're apart. It's really important. Those of you who can, may step forward and add a little bend and come back. Some of you might be stepping forward, adding the arm, and others who are more able may step forward and put both arms out. Remember, you've got your chair there for support or a wall. Okay, you ready? And let's go. One, and back. And two, and back. Remember, if it's too much, you step in, just step in and coming back. Step in, we're on the same leg. If you can, stay on that same leg. Do it about six or seven. Stop at any time. And resting. Okay, so we're going to turn around, but we're going to turn to your chair. It's safer. So turn round to your chair and face the other side. Now, Barbara, you've got that knee problem on there. I would not do this if you've got a knee problem. If your knees are really aching, the other exercise you can do is you sit down on your chair, and you do a leg extension. And you're just lifting the leg up and holding it and bringing it down. And lift. Right, so we're going to do those lunges on the other leg, but this is an alternative exercise to do. You're sitting right back in your chair to support your back there. You ready, girls? Ready for lunges? Do some lunges. Back nice and tall, feet apart. There. Ready, and one, and back, and two, and back, and three. You need to reduce it, it's just that step, and back, and forward, and back, and forward, good, and back, so keep that back tall, and back, and lift, and back, two more. Remember, if you're seated, lifting up, back against there, lift up, see if you can hold. And resting, girls. Right, so I'd like you to face your chair, feet apart. Stay down. If you don't want to get up, stay seated. You can do the same exercise on seated. Feet apart. There. Brenda, can we put your top over there? I took it off, haven't you? I get a bit concerned about anything hanging on back of chairs in case it tips. Okay. Scarf's alright. Right, we're ready? So we're going to do calf raises. Okay, feet apart. Ready, and one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, seven, and to your tiptoes, eight, think about being on your big toe and next toe to it, don't go over onto your little toes, up and down, good, up and resting, Well, right, have you all got your bands?
Yes.
Yeah. Either the bands or tins, some weights. If you haven't got those, you're just going to use your own body weight today. Yes, pink's good for you, pink's good for you. Anybody else? No, anyone else is okay. They're clean if you should need a band.
Okay, darling, thank you.
When they use them, they have to chuck them on the floor.
Yep.
That's the rule. Use them, chuck them on the floor. Right, girls. Seated. You want to go seated, G? You can stay standing if you want to work more standing. I don't mind. You've got your cushion there. Right. So we're going to do the tray. So, there. Picking the band up, there. So the closer your hands are in a band, the harder it's going to be. Most people start this one about there. So if you've got weight, you do exactly the same. Right. So we've got elbows in, that's the important bit, elbows stay in. Right, so you're going to pull. And then you slide your hands back, keep them close. If you're feeling strong, you can pull again. That's the hard bit, the second pull. If it's too much, just hold where you are, and then release and come forward. What I want you to focus on is when you go back, you do a little squeeze as well. So you're working these muscles on the shoulder blades. Squeeze back. Okay, so I want you to really focus on that. Squeeze at the back. Right, we're ready. And pull. This is a tough thing, this is a tough exercise. Back. Elbows in. Squeeze. And then if you're feeling stronger, pull. Breathe. Now, don't hold your breath. Very easy to do in this exercise. And release. And pull. Back we go. Squeeze. And then if you're feeling strong, pull. Breathing in. Breathing out. Tricky. And release. A few more. Remember, you can stop at any time. This is really good for strengthening up that upper back. Squeeze, pull. We need to keep this one strong. Keeps your posture, stops you bending forward. And release. And rest. Well done. If your shoulders are a bit tired, move them around. Get some more oxygen in there. Okay. Next exercise is for the hips. So we bring the feet and knees together to start with. Feet and knees together, you get the band and you're wrapping it underneath.
So stand behind?
You can, yeah, or they can do. It's really difficult. So if you've got somebody who can't stand and they're seated and they haven't got a band,
Tricky.
I usually get them to just do tap outs.
Yeah.
Tap outs. Because if you can't stand them, they're behind the chair.
Yeah.
You can't do it.
Yeah.
No.
Can't do
that. I think that's more advanced.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's an alternative. But anyway, we've all got bands. Carrie's doing it as though she hasn't got a band or weights and she can't stand. Alright? Okay. There. Feet apart. So it depends on how strong you're feeling as how tight you have that band. So you might just keep it loose. It's not too small, Brendan. That's because you're trying to wrap it round twice. Just put it through and bring the band to there. Now cross it. And then pull it. Excellent. See? There's a method in my madness. Right, there. And press out. So if that's too much, you can loosen your band off. If it's too easy, tighten your band. And press. So we're aiming to put the knees as over the ankle joint. If you're doing side tap taps out, just gently doing the side tap out, alternating the leg each time. And release. And press. Right, let's think about our posture too. Back up tall, relax the shoulders down, and release. And press. So we're having a little hold. Two, three, and release. And press. Two, three, release. And press. Two, three, release. And press. Two, three, release. And press. Three, release. Press. One more. Let's have a little hold this time. Little hold. Three, two, one, and rest. Oh, well done. We need to work. We need it to be a little bit harder sometimes. That little bit of overload helps get those muscles stronger. Okay? It's got to be done. Right. Right, so we're going to do triceps. Okay? Got this muscle here at the back. All right. We're going to do it this way, where we put the band underneath our foot. We have a long bit at the side, and then we have to hold it there. So the tail is coming out the back and it's going across the hand there, and we hold it. The closer your hand is to your feet, the harder it's going to be. So start off with it quite easy first. You can soon alter the resistance. Right, let's get the back up tall. Right, so I want you to lift it up first and bend it inwards. Bend it there, keep it in. Now push behind. So if you've got the weight, you're going to be picking it up and pushing behind, so it's straight. And release. And up. And press. So with the weight, you might be able to do two pushes out to our hold. And release. And up, and press back, and hold. Push out, one, two, and release. And lift, and press back. Push back there to work that back muscle, the tricep. Now, it doesn't get used a lot in everyday life, the tricep, not as much as we'd like to use it, because we need to be doing this sort of action. And I don't clean my windows every day. So I'm not doing this action every day and release. But you do need to work it because it's the muscle that helps you get out of problems like low chairs, the bath. If you should have a little fall, you need to get up. These are the muscles that you need to work. Okay, so it's quite important. Up, press back. Push back there. And release. And up, and press back. Push there, three, two, one, and release. So you might want to do more of those as you get stronger. Up to 10, okay? Right, let's try the other side. Other side. So back up nice and tall. Back up nice and tall. There, so. Lifting it up, and then we're going to push it straight behind. Let's get that resistance. You're all right there. And release. And lift. And press back. And release. And up. And press back. Hold it. And release. If you've got the band, pulling it up, pressing it back straight, keeping it close. Don't push it out. Keep it close to the chair. And your body, and then release, and up, and press back, push that arm straight, get that tricep working, and release. One more. This time we'll have a little hold. Let's have a little hold. Push it there, hold, three, two, one, and release. Okay. I think we can put our bands away now. A bit of stretching. Finish the class. Okay? and taking the arms behind. Pull back. Pull back. Have a stretch there. Everybody feeling okay?
Yeah.
Well done. And release. Right, let's do that. So you've done all these stretches before. This is a shoulder stretch. So remember your hand on the shoulder, hand above your elbow bit, and then press that arm towards your neck or chest area to get the stretch on the shoulder here. And release. Other one. And press. Hold it there. Remember to breathe in and out through the stretches. Because we're not moving, we tend to just breathe in and forget the breathing out. It's very important. And release. Okay, let's do the calf stretch. So if you're sat down now, you will bring one foot forward. You need to be at the edge of your chair. And then your leg can be straight. Remember, it's hip, knee, and foot in line. Hand on the thigh and lean forward. I think this is a really strong calf stretch. Just be careful. If it's too much, sit back up a little bit. And then if it feels okay, sit forward a little bit. Try and not let your back sink down forward. Keep it straight. And change. Other leg. So in the cool down, we tend to hold the stretches a little bit longer. So that could be anything up 8 seconds plus. Okay, a little bit longer, because we're all nice and warm and flexible, so we can increase our stretch. Breathe. A nice time to try and relax as well. Breathing in and breathing out. And coming back up. Back nice and tall. Okay, so let's do the shoulders up and down and down. Nice and steady. Up and down. Try and control them, breathing in. Breathing out. Breathing in. Breathing out. Okay, let's just turn the head to look over. And forward. And the other way. And forward. And ear to shoulder. Just gently, if you can get, keep your chin forward. Don't let your chin turn to your shoulder. Ear to shoulder and up, and gently over the other way, and up. Okay, so just before we finish, and we stand up, you may want to stand up, do a little bit of circulation boosting first, helps your blood get back to your head, okay, prevents you going feeling a little bit dizzy when you get up. Nice and steady there. Okay, so we're going to do some standing. So we take the feet back. Remember, feet back go a little bit. And then you're coming forward and pushing through. Push through your legs. Maybe if you've got a frame, you might need to hold on to that. And walking round. To the back of your chair, holding on. Just your feet moving a little bit more. Well done, everybody.